I'm Tom, I'm from Northern Ireland and I've been living in Beijing for 10 years. At the end of this month, I'm heading back home. And in my time in Beijing, I've fallen in love with trail running, particularly these kind of adventurous trails. And for me, the amazing thing about this challenge was it was a kind of goodbye to the mountains of Beijing for me, which I've spent so much time in over the last 10 years.
我十分喜欢越野跑，我喜欢在大自然里看风景。虽然脚踝受伤了，一年还没好利索，但是我的好朋友白瑞要提前回国，我想和他一起把曾经设计的这条路线跑完，作为他回国前最好的礼物。
下来以后就好说了，就是我说那个峡谷，大概有10公里长左右的一个峡谷，就，第二个补给点在这儿，在这个位置，就是上北陵之前。
你要是去田庄的话，还要再回到101再往回走。我不知道我的脚到这儿什么状态了，但是我推测可能也就是连跑带走，然后这8公里就是溜溜达达过去。
你还带了其他鞋子？
带了3双鞋子。
怎么回事？路上随时换。
对，
我觉得明天早上不会比这个太冷太多。
一点风都没有的东陵，其实挺难得的，就是一丝风都没有，几乎。已经搜好行程了。哎，对，这次全程都在北京境内，没有去成西陵，但实际上，里程只少了10几公里，大概少了1000多爬升吧。就是现在改版的这个路线也有它的意义。 从出发开始，首先是登顶北京最高峰，从北京最高峰一路向北京的城区挺进，最终回到你最熟悉的地方，我觉得也是特别有意义，非常梦幻的这种感觉，就是你头天在灵山看日出，看完日出，我跟白瑞说，我说好，现在我们回象山，就感觉好像马上就要回去的那种感觉。 但是我们知道即将要面对的是什么，就是经过挣扎了一天和一夜以后，等我们真的回到香山地区，看到那么多朋友了也好，然后看到熟悉的这个山啊，自己日常训练的这些小径也好，会让你觉得昨天发生的那一切真的好像做梦一样。
However, because we're preparing for it over 6 months, we've seen these routes in very different seasons of the year, which is always interesting because the difference in the seasons in Beijing is pretty stark. For a challenge as big as this, you have to do like an emotional preparation as well. It's not just about physical preparation, it's about understanding in your mind and maybe something deeper than that as well about what you're about to do. And of course the previous times that we were supposed to run it, I was in that space where I was prepared for it and then we had to postpone. So that's quite kind of mentally taxing. The biggest challenge for me, which Haiguai didn't seem to have, but on the first day it was way hotter than we had expected. And also that section of the route, so like the first 40 kilometers, is at altitude and it's very exposed. There's no shade and the sun is super strong. And that really affected me, actually. That was probably the biggest challenge for me. And my body was not in a good state. And the weird thing was I could feel that my legs were fine. I could feel that I had strength and energy, in my body, but the sun had just hit me like a wall.
在对方不论心理上还有说行动上都是有互相依赖的这种时刻，就是我状态好的时候我会告诉你接下来咱们是不是把这个进度整体提前一下，我们下一个补给站是不是可以压缩一下这个补给的时间，状态不好的时候呢可能就说互相安慰吧，就说我也这样了，然后那咱们不如这一段就稍微慢一点就走着走吧。
这个山从这沟上翻到公路上以后基本上第一段爬升就算结束了，然后后面基本上都是下。
我叫来的这些好朋友，他们对我最大的帮助就是让我在整个挑战中都始终处于一个比较放松的状态，因为以这么一条线为基础，大家都能在不同的分段中找到自己乐趣。我非常珍惜这种感觉，就是说大家这么多人就是能聚在一起玩，然后觉得是非常难得的体验。
In terms of this route, I think there's very few races in the world that would be as hard as this. This is not a route that's designed for speed. No one can run this at speed. The routes are too technical. The paths are very rocky. There's a lot of areas you can't really run. And it's really built for that. It's a route built for mountain lovers, basically.
刷了一下，
你要换衣服吗？
一会儿换。
这段体力和精神都受到了折磨，简直是。
咱们按这个进度走呗，一会儿收拾收拾就走。
我们今天到河南台的，我们
要到。再喝点咖啡。
拜拜，
拜拜。
With a lot of these situations where you spend a long time with one person, you actually end up spending a lot of your time in silence. I'm sure that like 60% of the time that me and Haiguai were running together, we were not talking to each other. But sometimes it feels like there's a kind of communication going on anyway, because you're doing a thing together.
更多的聊的可能就是说他回国以后的打算，因为我们都是比较重度的路线的这个规划，就是爱好者吧，可能会聊一些他回国以后打算探索的路线啊，参加的比赛也好，然后以及这些比赛这些路线的优点都在哪。毕竟两个人要一起面对困难，还得互相安慰，就是没有互相安慰也很难说走回终点。
还好就是这块没出什么幺蛾子就不错了。
So we had a lot of people who joined us as pacers. I mean, we were calling them pacers, but this route was never about the pace, right? So it's not like a marathon pacer trying to keep us on a time. It wasn't about that. It was about having company. And it was about, I think anyway, it was about making this thing that me and Haiguai wanted to do into a kind of thing for the community, a kind of celebration for the community of trail runners in Beijing.
From 河南台出发的时候是晚上11:40，我特意确认了这个时间。事实上，整个过程中我俩都在挣扎，就是非常痛苦。是因为脚踝这个确实是一个比较大的隐患，它会让你一直处于焦虑，你不知道这个雷会不会爆发，或者说你现在康复的程度能不能承受得了你现在这个路线的运动强度。当时我爆发了以后，发现白瑞跟我一模一样的症状，就是我俩没有任何关节上的疼痛，都是大腿特别酸特别胀。这次的路况确实是特别有难度导致的这个情况，但我觉得有一定程度上也有我不太敢让患侧发力的这种感觉。
That period over the night was, as I mentioned, it was probably the hardest section of the whole run for us. So a lot of my mind was on, just trying to convince myself, one foot in front of the other, keep going. You'll feel better physically and mentally when the sun comes up. Those kind of conversations, yeah.
真的确实是这么长距离，我从来没有进行过超过100公里的这样的自主式的越野跑探索。超长的距离，超过100公里以后，对你的规划，然后整个路线的这个熟悉程度都有非常高的要求。
拍我也不跑。
A 100-mile route in the mountains that you've kind of designed yourself around geography, around these kind of geographical features that you want to travel across. It's very different from a race. Firstly, of course, the reason you're there is not to be number one or top 10 or whatever. That's not the point. The point is to complete the route and experience everything that's thrown at you along the way.
8-10 kilometers 跑得太嘚瑟了，然后出到河南台就深深的被教育了一下，然后出了河南台的到禅房就废了。
感觉还挺好的，觉得这个活动挺有意思的，然后那个补给特别的好，我吃了得有大半锅的羊肉，
不止。
然后那个所有露牙的部分都给我掐了啊。
With the way that we called this adventure, Haiguai's present, it's an interesting present because it was damn hard and a lot of parts were not pleasurable. But there are a lot of incredible surprises in there as well. And there are some quite special things, and particularly with the fact that I'm leaving China really soon and I've spent so much time playing in the mountains here and enjoying the mountains here. This journey has been hard, but quite special. So in that sense, it was a present. Yeah, it really was a present.
今天回顾坐下来结束了坐下来我就想到我就觉得就是我很庆幸也就真的是很感谢就是户外探险来办这个事情我有机会参与
我说如果有机会的话我也想来参加我说我可以来给你们做补给啊来给当 pacer 啊他说好啊那然后我们就后来就来了我觉得非常非常开心非常开心
When Tom told me first time about this challenge, I directly thought, oh, what a great event to run all the way from Lingshan to Xiangshan and to cross all the mountains in Beijing's west. And when he was then asking for pacers, I directly raised my hand as I really wanted to be also part of this event.
因为白瑞他也是学历史的嘛，然后我们经常也会聊，就是他也知道很多中国的历史，然后就是我说我们今天跑的这个路线，刚才我们从那个黄草梁下来那条路，实际上就是北京以前到怀来的一条非常重要的、非常有历史的一条古道，啊，是很有趣的。通过越野跑的方式把这些体验全部都串起来，我觉得那可能是我能想象到的关于北京西山的一个最好的一个礼物了。
I haven't run such a long distance yet, so my longest was around 60 kilometers, and that's why I thought to still be able to pace him, I better just join for a section, but I'm also now really willing to do longer distances, so maybe in future I can be able to do a similar distance than Tom, let's see.
把肺都快烧光了那种感觉就是但是我觉得很好我从来没在这条线上可能我不知道速度有没有我还没看是不是我跑过最快的但是我觉得从体会从直觉感受来说可能是我最卖力的一次奔跑夏安口这一带的最深的它是一种就是喀斯特岩溶地貌啊是很因为永定河深切是带来了这样一个北方典型的北方的岩溶地貌啊非常有趣啊然后而且呢还伴随着它有一条就是我们这一条是一条特别大的一条断裂带，就是这个叫这个就是岩合成断裂带。
Not always. So sometimes he also was really quiet, and then his answers were really short. And then I sensed that maybe he doesn't want to talk at the moment. And then I gave him some time. Yeah. His wife changed in the end, and so many other friends and runners. So I think that's really great that he could share this with so many people that he likes a lot.
那其实我也是很怀念有比赛，因为它能够有完善的这个过程，但它可能有一点就是路线是规定很安全，可能作为我目前这个能力自主探险能力的水平，可能比赛我觉得 OK， 让我经历到很多之前我还没有参与到的这些路线，然后就是让有就是有这么多人一起去上山玩这个事情，我觉得这个。作为我来说，这个事情从去年八月份到现在，我觉得是我这两年很好的一个理由。不好意思。
探索式的这种开辟这种约跑路线的话呢，肯定会对于我们整个约跑社区的话呢，会有一个带动或者说一个促进的这样的一个作用。
不仅是亲自参与的朋友，还有看到我们这些视频内容的朋友，能对于我们的山野有更好的期待，也有一些更好的希望。也希望我们这些每一位热爱山野的朋友，我们可以随心所欲地畅跑在山野里边。
通过这样的一个片子，能够让我们，不仅仅是沉浸在这个自然当中，另外的话呢，也能让我们其实了解到更多的是越野跑的一个动机。
everything we have to face it. Without a sound, we take a step. Inside our hearts are racing. If it takes forever, we'll get there together. I'm winding along this road, not knowing where it will go. No matter what life brings, if it's you and me, we're ready. For